And then sometimes I like to do some side EQing where I'm changing the shape of the V. What do I mean with this shape of the V thing? What am I talking about? Well, if we have a very narrow V, this would be pop music, dance track. So all the low end is just kick, snare. There's nothing that's panned out that's got any kind of meat to it at all. And what you have panned is high sparkle stuff that gives you a sense of width. The phrase of overproduced comes from the shape of the V being too pop for what their expectation is for the style. Altering subtly, not pissing off anybody, the shape of the side low end, literally the shape of the whole mix, so that it becomes more produced or less, is part of the gig. So I did the pop V. Let's do this kind of V. This would be like a, I don't know, modern rock, Back in Black, Audioslave, where you've got some girthy kind of low end going out on the sides, but not so much that you destroy the punch. And then you've got sort of maybe alternative music or some kind of more experimental sounding things where you really lose the punch in the center because you're interested in this very real low mids and low end on the sides. From a production standpoint, that's very important to think about. How are you shaping the low end in the mix? Does it suit the style of the single, the artist? How do the different songs on a record vary in how that low end is panned and cut? And how does that interplay with how people perceive? You know, back in the day, the punk rock quip about something, well, it's overproduced. Well, what that basically meant was it was like too clean.